Blackstone Publishing presents The Good Ancestor, A Radical Prescription for Long-Term Thinking by Roman Krznaric. This book is read by Joe Jameson.
The most important question we must ask ourselves is, are we being good ancestors? Jonas Salk. It's 3:23 in the morning, and I can't sleep, because my great-great-grandchildren ask me in dreams, what did you do while the earth was unravelling? Drew Dellinger. Preface. Coronavirus, COVID-19, spread worldwide just as this book was going to press. The pandemic has understandably focused our attention on the here and now, with families, communities, business and governments acting to confront the fierce urgency of the crisis. In the midst of such an immediate threat, what insights does long-term thinking offer? Most obviously, those countries that had already made long-term preparations for possible pandemics have so far been able to deal with the virus most effectively. While Taiwan had virus testing and tracing mechanisms in place following its experience of the 2003 SARS outbreak, the US response was hampered by having disbanded the National Security Council's pandemic unit in 2018. At the same time, the catastrophic impacts of coronavirus are a stark reminder that we should be thinking, planning, and budgeting for multiple risks that lie on the horizon. Not only the threat of further pandemics, but the climate crisis and unchecked technological developments. Humanity's response to the virus will clearly have long-term consequences that ripple into the decades ahead. Many governments may try to cling on to the emergency powers they have granted themselves, such as heightened citizen surveillance, leaving an authoritarian residue that undermines new democratic possibilities. On the other hand, the rupture that the pandemic has caused may open space for a fundamental rethink of our politics, economies, and lifestyles. Just as pioneering long-term institutions such as welfare states and the World Health Organization emerged from the ashes of the Second World War, so too could coronavirus trigger the long-term thinking now needed to challenge the dangers of short-termism and build resilience in the face of a very uncertain future. By making wise and long choices at this time of crisis, we could well become the good ancestors that future generations deserve. Oxford, March 2020. Part 1. The Tug of War for Time. Chapter 1. How can we be good ancestors? We are the inheritors of gifts from the past. Consider the immense legacy left by our ancestors, those who sowed the first seeds in Mesopotamia 10,000 years ago, who cleared the land, built the waterways, and founded the cities where we now live, who made the scientific discoveries, won the political struggles, and created the great works of art that have been passed down to us. We seldom stop to think about how they have transformed our lives. Most of their names have been forgotten by history. But among those who are remembered is the medical researcher Jonas Salk. In 1955, after nearly a decade of painstaking experiments, Salk and his team developed the first successful and safe polio vaccine. It was an extraordinary breakthrough. At the time, polio paralyzed or killed over 500,000 people worldwide each year. Salk was immediately hailed as a miracle worker. But he was not interested in fame and fortune. He never sought to have the vaccine patented. His ambition was to be of some help to humankind and to leave a positive legacy for future generations. There's no doubt he succeeded. In later years, Salk expressed his philosophy of life in a single question: are we being good ancestors? He believed that just as we have inherited so many riches from the past, we must also pass them on to our descendants. He was convinced that in order to do so, and to confront global crises such as humanity's destruction of the natural world and the threat of nuclear war, we needed a radical shift in our temporal perspective towards one far more focused on long-term thinking and the consequences of our actions beyond our own lifetimes. Rather than thinking on a scale of seconds, days, and months, we should extend our time.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.